these are the words the public has come to associate with internationally recognized surgeon Dr. Sheldon Sevinor. Named Boston's best plastic surgeon by the Improper Bostonian magazine, he's famous enough among the Nipentuckerati to be crowned simply as Sevinor.
It is a new trend called down aging.
We're redefining what it means to age in today's society.
Speaking of eyelids,
she loves this story.
Plastic surgery to nip, snip, and tuck everything, from the unsightly to the slightly imperfect, is growing.
The media across the world constantly calls on Dr. Sevinor as a trusted resource.
Dr. Sevinor, is there a point at which you say to a patient, all right, this is too many procedures, you know?
Many times.
Employers want more than hard work. They also want a youthful image.
It's a facelift for plastic surgery.
The latest wrinkle, the growing number of baby boomers fine-tuning their looks.
Dr. Sevinor has helped thousands of people feel better about their self-image and to capture a better version of themselves.
One recent trend we've noticed is the increase in the number of young women seeking cosmetic procedures.
He has taught the art and science of cosmetic surgery to colleagues in seminars nationally and internationally. In addition to heading the Sevinor Institute of Cosmetic Surgery in Boston, Dr. Sevinor is affiliated with several hospitals, including the prestigious Massachusetts Eye and Ear Infirmary, a teaching affiliate of Harvard Medical School. He is certified by the National Board of Medical Examiners and the American Board of Cosmetic Surgery, the Massachusetts Society of Plastic Surgery, the American Society of Liposuction Surgery, and an honorary member of the European Academy of Cosmetic Surgery.
Okay, now why do you want bigger lips? Because I've had big lips all my life, and I never could I have imagined that this was going to become the craze. I just, really, go ahead.
He has come to represent an honest and knowledgeable friend to the viewing public and the broadcast industry with his numerous appearances on ABC World News Tonight with Peter Jennings, The Oprah Winfrey Show, PBS, Inside Edition, Germany's Pro 7 TV and Satellite 1 TV, Brazil's Global TV, Eye on America with Dan Rather, Discovery Health Network, Good Morning America, CNN World News, Fox National News, Sally Jesse Raphael, Geraldo, and Japan National TV.
Hi, I'm Joan Rivers.
And I'm Dr. Sheldon Sevinor.
I'm glad you're a great plastic surgeon.
As America's workforce ages, workers increasingly encounter an unpleasant truth. Many employers want more than hard work. They also want a youthful image, one available through surgery. And as Bill Whitaker reports in tonight's Eye on America, it no longer requires a star on your dressing room door.
In Hollywood, where growing old gracefully is unheard of, some of the most creative artists aren't the ones on the red carpet. It's their plastic surgeons. A lift here, a tuck there is a way of life, and not just in Hollywood these days.
Okay, this is Beverly Hills, but plastic surgery is changing the face of America. Take a look at these numbers. Procedures are up more than threefold nationwide since 1992, from Omaha to Iowa City, even button-down Boston.
Where retired workers, 63-year-old Jan Ruscio and her husband Tony, 65, don't want to look old when they feel...
30? No, I feel young inside. I when I say I'm 63, it's a number.
You don't have all that excess skin.
Jan had her eyes lifted and wrinkles chemically peeled away. Tony had a facelift. They were so pleased they went back under the knife together to smooth his eyes and plump her lips.
We're both aging and we can't get away from that.
Like she said, I do it for you, you do it for me, we do it for each other.
There are 72 million baby boomers out there that feel more active and more vital than ever before, and they want to look their best.
This is World News Tonight with Peter Jennings.
How do you feel?
Wonderful.
Great.
After a facelift and chemical peel, Sandra Wolf started buying skincare products developed by her doctor.
There's a cleanser.
And sold in his office.
I think I have more knowledge as a plastic surgeon about how that patient should take care of their skin than somebody behind a cosmetics counter.
Wolf says it's convenient for her, and she trusts her doctor.
I would not think he was going to try to sell me something that I shouldn't have.
57-year-old Anne hated her flabby neck. She thought it made her look older than she felt.
It was starting to hang, and I just felt that I couldn't live with this.
So 6 months ago, Anne underwent a procedure called neck sculpting, and in just a few days, she was good as new.
Within 2 days, I had people in for dinner.
Most of my patients can go back to work with a turtleneck on in about 3 or 4 days.
And people shouldn't even be able to tell you've had it done.
People would come in and say, I know something happened to you, but I can't figure out. Was it a lot of weight loss?
Today, right before your eyes, you're going to see a plastic surgeon perform a new technique called the Paris lip. Our guest is Boston plastic surgeon, Dr. Sheldon Sevinor. And in the chair, ready to get her lips all powdered up, is Julie Loveland. We're glad to have you both on the show. Okay, now why do you want bigger lips? Because I've had big lips all my life, and I never could I have imagined that this was going to become the craze. I just, really, go ahead. Okay, we're back. And Julie, what big lips you have. Take a look at the before picture of Julie's lips. Notice that upper lip. That's what you're basically looking at,
yes,
because that's what was injected. Upper lip. And after. Oh, see, that's show you before. Big difference, huh?
Absolutely.
Would you say that is a more kissable lip?
Very much so. I would kiss that lip.
You would kiss that lip. Okay. Now, what is a collagen injection, say, for these laugh line tear? And since you've been on the show, I'm sure it's going to be a lot cheaper. Really?
Of course.
No, I'm only kidding. I'm only kidding.
What are you doing this afternoon?
I'm only kidding. It's against the law to do that. Okay. Dr. Sevinor will be up a little later on when we're going to meet a woman who went from a size 12 to a size 6 with liposuction in about an hour. So, it does not sound bad to me. We've been waiting to talk to you about that size 12 to size 6. You actually looked a little heavier than a 12 there to me, so maybe, I don't know.
I could have been. I was wearing nothing but sweatsuits.
We've been saying it was in an hour. Did you get it all taken out at one time? All
yes.
The fat taken out at one time?
Yes, at one time in the hospital. Well, Dr. Sevinor is an absolute perfectionist to a fault.
Uh-huh.
I've never been to a doctor that gives you more before and after care.
Okay. So you had lots of before.
He's compulsive about it.
It is a new trend called down aging, and you're going to see what one 80-year-old woman decided to do, how far she decided to go.
Looks like a grandmother, cooks like a grandmother, but 80-year-old Phyllis Porter is about to shatter everything you thought you knew about what it means to be old.
I always was conventional. I always did what I was supposed to do. Now I'm going to do what I want to do. I've earned the privilege. That's the way I feel.
I've been in practice 23 years here in Boston. I've done over 1,000 breast augmentations, and even some people, some women in their 50s, but I've never done someone who was 80 years old. She said, well, I'm going to be your first.
And Phyllis is getting the works: a facelift, a chemical peel, an eye lift, lip enlargement, and breast implants. Phyllis is part of a trend her doctor calls down-aging. People over 65 having surgery to make them look as young as they feel.
I did it. I mean it.
What it really means is that we're reinterpreting what it means to get older. Older is becoming better.
I don't want to think about pills. I don't want to think about cemetery lots. I want to think about living.
Here she is before, and here she is months after recovery. Before, after.
I love the way I look. This is the way I always want to look.
I'm trying to shut my mouth here. I'm still like this.
Phyllis, wow. Did you?
All right. Thank you, Tom Brokaw. Obviously, in Washington, particularly with the Bush administration, a lot of effort now to save face, which coincidentally is what we're talking about today with Phyllis Diller.
I would say that there is no pain with any kind of cosmetic procedure.
The fact is that I call this whole thing down aging. The fastest growing trend in cosmetic surgery of people in their 70s and 80s. People are living longer today than ever before, they're healthier than ever, and they're more active. When I think of people years ago, like my grandmother when she was 65, I felt that she was an elderly woman at 65. Today, 65 is the beginning of the second half of your life.
Every patient is different because every patient has a different image of themselves. And that's why it's important that the plastic surgeon be a good psychologist.
But what when Kathy looks in the mirror, she longs for fuller lips and fewer lines.
Corner of each lip.
What implants have done for the bust line, new facial implants will do for Kathy's mouth.
It gives it structural support underneath the wrinkle and thereby elevates the wrinkle and makes it look less conspicuous.
Fulfilling her dreams of a pouty mouth, Dr. Sevinor marks where the implant will eventually go. But first, Kathy has one nagging question.
Will I feel different when my husband kisses me?
No, that's a good question. No, people tell me that they do not lose feeling of the lip and it feels very natural.
Today's show is all about plastic surgery breakthroughs. Dr. Sheldon Sevinor from Boston.
People don't realize how much psychology is involved in plastic surgery. It's so important for the plastic surgeon to understand why someone wants to change their image and to not operate on everybody that walks into your office.
So if someone says, I want to undo the way I look, I want to change my image totally, what do you say?
In my Boston office, I often have people come back two or three times because I want to be sure that that person's doing it for themselves. Just like Cindy, she wanted to feel better about herself, not because of her husband, and that's key. If someone thinks that having a breast enlargement is going to save their marriage, they're the wrong candidate.
Today's headline story, one recent trend we've noticed is the increase in the number of young women seeking cosmetic procedures. But April Woodard reports it's not just young people who are going under the knife.
They're both patients of Dr. Sheldon Sevinor in Boston.
We wouldn't do any cosmetic surgery on anyone, whether they're 30 or whether they're in their 80s, if they weren't in great health.
The fact is, people are living longer and they want to look younger.
In the last 2 years, cosmetic surgery for men and women over 65 years old has increased over 400%.
And the results are nothing short of amazing. That's 88-year-old Stephanie 6 weeks after her chemical peel. Check her out before and after.
I'm crazy happy with the whole result.
Down aging is the fastest trend in my practice right now. I think because people are living longer than ever before in today's society. And when they look in the mirror, they don't feel as old as they look. She said, I might live 10 more years, 20 more years. I'm in great health. I feel great. But you know what, doctor? I'm not going to wake up to these two pancakes the rest of my life. And I said, what are you asking for? And she said, I would like some enhancement of my breasts.
Right now. Hey,
hey, yeah, yeah. 76-year-old Gladys Sargent had her first cosmetic surgery in 1988. An eye lift, a facelift, a nose job, and a chemical peel, all done at once.
I was so excited. I could not wait to do it. And as they were wheeling me down to the OR, I said to myself, boy, this is the greatest adventure of my life.
Gladys says she did it to boost her sagging self-esteem.
It was a kick, really. And it's carried me right through.
The number of cosmetic surgeries performed on people age 65 and older has more than tripled in 4 years, up from 121,000 in 1997 to 425,000 in 2001.
You found for me?
Boston plastic surgeon Dr. Sheldon Sevinor specializes in nipping and tucking those in their sixth decade and beyond.
So I tell my patients, it's okay. You don't have to apologize to want to undergo cosmetic surgery, assuming you're healthy, if you're in your 60s, 70s, or even in your 80s today.
Dr. Sevinor says advanced age itself is no reason to avoid having cosmetic surgery. He's more compulsive about safeguards with the 65-plus group.
By getting medical clearance with their own personal physician, getting clearance from the anesthesia department, and have it in a safe setting, that is, in a hospital environment.
Gladys Sargent's recovery took almost 3 weeks, but she says she'd do it all again in a heartbeat.
I'd say to every woman, go for it.
You've got a very pretty mom. Do you think that that was part of your motivation? Because it looks like in some ways you look more like her now than you did before. Was that part of your motivation, do you think?
People do comment on that a lot more now since I've had my surgeries, but I think it's part of me, like, maturing and growing into.
And when I met Natalie for the first time, the major difference in her nose isn't from the side view. I think you have a front view, and perhaps you could tell. It was the width of her nose, and I knew that wasn't going to change. And I knew that she had a great deal of fatty tissue. And I knew that the jawline and the neck wasn't going to change because of genetics.
All right, but let me ask you a question.
Mm-hmm.
What's the youngest person you've ever had come to say, I want you to do something to my face?
I've had many people come into my office at 13 and 14 with their mothers,
okay,
teenagers, and the child will sit in the chair and they may have an unattractive nose and the mother may say, she looks so beautiful if she had her nose done. And I'll say to the child, what do you think of your nose? And the child will say, I love my nose.
Okay.
That's the patient you never operate
okay
on. There are many young teenagers that look in magazines and they bring me a photograph and they say, this is what I'd like my nose to look like. I don't want to do that patient. It's not realistic. And, you know, we all have different bone structure, and
true,
someone who's bringing me a picture from a magazine, I know they'll never be satisfied.
We are more than the packaging that we come in. I'm Dr. Joy Brown.
Now on WBZ 4 News.
This strive for perfection has landed a lot of baby boomers in the operating room. Dr. Sheldon Sevinor sees his share of patients who don't want to age gracefully.
We're redefining what it means to age in today's society.
Chronicle, New England's nightly news magazine.
Sisters Mary, Karen, Joy, and Nancy say they tried everything. Ate right, exercised religiously, but they could not lose that stubborn fat from their hips and thighs. The North Shore women say they inherited their figure flaws from their mother. But Mary decided to change her fate by putting it in the hands of this man, Dr. Sheldon Sevinor, a Boston plastic and reconstructive surgeon. Sevinor's recommendation, liposuction.
The number of fat cells that we have are predetermined at the time of puberty. What happens is they expand or they shrink over time. And when we do liposuction, we're removing those fat cells. If a person gains weight, they will gain weight in other areas, but it will not come back in the areas that we're doing liposuction on.
Sister Joy, who says the only time she was thin was the day she was born, was next to opt for the procedure.
Before, what I used to look like is that when I put my arms down, my arms came out like this. They never touched at all because my hips were so big. Now, afterwards, I mean, everything touches.
There's an expression, down aging. And what it means is that you and I are looking and feeling better than our parents and grandparents did when they were our age. And that's because we have more choices available to us. Only a plastic surgeon could have created the Primage skincare system. A doctor who knows and understands every aspect of the skin and its functions. An expert who has targeted the crucial component in fighting aging. At the Sevinor Center for Cosmetic Surgery in Boston, Dr. Sheldon Sevinor listens to what women have to say about aging, self-image, and the Primage skincare system.
You all bring out the point that you don't have to apologize to want to look your best.
Oh,
that's
no
important. Give yourself permission.
No.
Give yourself permission, men and women, to
absolutely
feel your best and look your best.
Well, absolutely.
You know, that brings up, absolutely. That brings up.
Da cirurgia, o médico mostra onde vai mexer.
rosto, pescoço. Ele vai ainda reduzir os seios da Sandra.
Meu espírito é jovem, eu nunca me envelheci.
They don't feel like they have
o Dr. Sevinor, médico das duas, concorda. Diz que as pessoas são mais ativas hoje, mais saudáveis, vivem mais, e que muitos dos pacientes dele, quando se olham no espelho, não se sentem tão velhos quanto aparentam. Suas mentes são jovens, ele completa. Tem que estar com uma saúde excelente, como a Sandra.
Speaking of eyelids,
the 81-year-old woman on Good Morning America today.
81-year-old.
This is a grandmother from Massachusetts. We're going to show the pictures. Never had anything done to herself. Decided it is my turn. I've earned this. She didn't stop with the eyes. She had her whole face done and her boobs. Let's see her before. Here's Phyllis Porter before.
She looks great.
She looks her age. Now there she is after.
Okay.
Where are the boobs? I want to see the boobs.
She had a facelift. An eye lift. She had breast enlargements. We have pictures of it. I don't know why they're not showing it.
Look at the boobs.
You go, Grandma. You go, Grandma.
Her friends at the coffee clutch are saying, well, you didn't have to do that. I mean, aren't you going to? Her husband said, I would have loved you anyway. The friends are saying,
I'm glad you're a great plastic surgeon. Don't change professions, you know what I mean? Join us.